Welcome to part 2, chapter 2, diversity and discrimination. In part 2, children, we are going to discuss about another evil, that is stereotype. Stereotype is labeling people and forcing them to behave accordingly. We say na stereotype behavior. We used to, a person who used to label other people or forcing them to behave accordingly as we want them to behave. It involves association of certain qualities to a certain group of people. This is primarily visible in the form of geographical differences, where certain qualities are associated with a boy and certain other are associated to a girl, which forces them to work and learn accordingly. This is called stereotype nature. We are differentiating between a girl and a boy. And we have not done. We are just following what our ancestors told us or taught us or tried to inculcate in within us through several years of practice. Anyhow, we need to understand that the individual, irrespective of their gender, have qualities according to their personality, whether a he gender or a she gender, male or a female gender, they have their own qualities according to their personality, not because of gender, and should likewise be respected. Stereotypes are not only created about gender, but also race, color, religion, and region, etc. Now, very important, remember, prejudice or preoccupied mind leads to the information of stereotypes. Let us be individual in our own right with our own set of strengths and weaknesses. Let us not live with borrowed experiences or expressions and unnatural personalities. Unnatural behavior causes stress, which affects the quality of life. Similarly, let us not use stereotypes to describe people of a place, community, or country as cunning, street smart, criminals, or lazy. These are negative brandings that lead to classes, violence, and animosity. The way we worship may be different, the way we celebrate may be different, and our ways may be different, but we all belong to one family, that is mankind. When we forget this, mankind moves towards disaster. Now, the third type of evil is discrimination, children. Discrimination means differentiation in your mind. Prejudice leads to stereotype followed with discrimination. All brothers and sisters all together. Discrimination is the opposite of equality. Means you are discriminating among a boy child and a girl child or vice versa. Discrimination is the opposite of equality. If equality means just and equal treatment to all in order to enjoy equal opportunities, then discrimination refers to actions taken on the basis of prejudice and stereotype. For example, people refusing to give their house on rent to people, particularly on the basis of region or religion, believing that they are violent and will perform illegal activities, which is very mean-minded. It's very mean and cheap mentality if you think like this. However, how would you feel if you are deprived of such an opportunity to dance, not because you are a poor dancer, but because you are not fair. You are not fair complexed. You are dark complexed. You have a dark complexion. Is this good? Talents are not being given importance rather than color. Very bad. How would you feel if you are not allowed to worship in a temple because you belong to a very particularly community, a low community, low caste community, very poor, very mean-minded children? You would probably feel angry and hurt at these unjust treatments. Similarly, people who face discrimination become bitter and angry with their life or with life. I repeat, this is very important, children. Similarly, people who face discrimination or differentiation become bitter and angry with life, right? Now, caste system. One of the prominent example of discrimination is the caste system. It consists of four varnas: Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Shudras. Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Shudras. The upper three castes were respected, but the Shudras were looked down upon. This practice started during ancient times. Initially, it was a system which divided our society on the basis of occupation. However, this system became rigid towards the end of Vedic period. A person born in a particular caste was forced to perform a particular set of tasks and follow a particular way of life. He or she was not allowed to change his or her occupation like it was earlier. The members of lower caste couldn't have a friendly relation with someone from a higher caste. People who performed activities such as cleaning, washing, cutting hair, picking garbage were seen as being dirty or impure. The caste system weakened our society and gave rise to hatred. However, there were people who worked for the betterment of Shudras or the lower caste. Some of them are Mahatma Gandhi, who worked towards reforming and uniting the society for the upliftment of Shudras. End of part 2.